I woke up one morning at about 3 o'clock in the morning and I said, we've got to do something better than Phillips Academy. Mm. We have to be able to, but we can't do, we don't have their resources. Mm. And so I, but what can we do? Well, do something that they're not doing. And they didn't have a dance department, and we did have. And the dance department was pretty good. It was modern dance, primarily. Went into Boston Symphony, because I knew the general manager of the symphony, and said, here's my idea. What about a school like this? And he said, hell, I don't know. That's not my field. But I'll tell you who would know. Gunther Schuller over the New England Conservatory. So he got me an introduction to New England Conservatory. And then he introduced me to Virginia Williams of Boston Ballet. Mm-hmm. And she introduced me to somebody down in Connecticut who was interested in the dance department. And so it was one thing built on top of the other. And then I presented to the board. What could they say?
After all is said and done, we need each other. For a million reasons we can't even name. All our roads still lead to one another. And for all we've been apart, we're still the same. Like the first time. Only better. We're a song that must be sung together. Like the first time, only this time, could it be forever? Wondering if we're lost in an illusion. Are we starting now? Did we never end? Our different dreams have reached the same conclusion and brought us here to fall in love again. Like the first time, only better. We're a song that must be sung together. Like the first time, only this time, could it be forever? Of love with you beside me. There's an ease to love we've never known before. And though I know the past is still inside me, I feel as if I've never loved you more. Like the first time, only we're a song that must be sung together. Like the first time, only this time, could it be forever? Like the first time, only better. We're a song that must be sung together. Like the the first time, only this time, it could be forever.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Walnut Hills School for the Arts. My name is Garrett Murphy from the class of 2008, celebrating my 15th reunion. Yay. And I'm delighted to welcome you here tonight as we celebrate Walnut Hills' 50th anniversary as a global leader of the arts, which in of itself is a remarkable feat. So let's have a round of applause for that. For the arts to survive another 50 years and beyond, collaboration is key. For folks to work together, not just as artists, but as human beings. And it is in that vein that many of the things that were programmed tonight were inspired. You just saw one of those such performances tonight done. They only got together this afternoon, and it's really quite remarkable when you think about it. But a very special thing and a sentiment to share with you all. Coming up a little bit later, we have an amazing project we've been working on for a few weeks with a current student in our Writing, Film, Media Arts program, a film to accompany La Valse by Ravel. And then there's some other things tonight as well that we're looking forward to sharing with you all, both here and at home. You were greeted earlier. I'm sure you're wondering what that was. But that was the very illustrious Grand Earl Batchelder, who served for a number of years as head of school at Walnut Hill, and indeed was the one that had the idea all those years ago for the school to become an arts leader, an arts school, and that was voted in March of 1971, and here we are many years later realizing that vision. And the first of the five awards we'll be giving out tonight is in his honor. It is the Earl Batchelder Award for Vision, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage, or actually we're going to have a video first, of a special tribute from some alums who could not be with us, but we wanted to share for the next award. So please enjoy.
Hi,
everyone. Hi, I'm Nicholas Christopher.
I'm Briga Heelan.
What class did you graduate in?
Oh, 08.
08, 05.
Yeah.
And we're here for a very, very special reason to talk about a Mr. Joe Cabral, who has served as Walnut Hill's director of theater since 1994.
94?
94.
That was before we were born.
Yeah, it was before we were both born.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a member of the Board of Trustees of the Massachusetts Educational Theater Guild and previously served on the board of the Educational Theater Association.
Yes, and his work has been celebrated and awarded all throughout the years, and we are so happy that we could be a small portion of that.
A small portion of it, absolutely. He had a vision to create a college-level theater training program, and he's guided and inspired so many of us. So we are very, very excited to announce the Earl Batchelder Award for Vision.
Goes to Joe Cabral.
Thank you, and we love you, Joe.
We love you, love you, love you.
It's right here. Hi, everybody. My name is Chloe Savitt. Obviously, I am not Joe Cabral, but I was his student. I graduated from the theater department in 2017. It is an immense joy and honor to be accepting this award on Joe Cabral's behalf. He is over at Mean Girls tonight, the opening. That's why he's not here. Joe holds his students to the absolute highest of standards and treats the Walnuts as though we're already working professionals. And that's something that really sticks with us as we enter the real world. And it shows in our work. Of course, everything I prepared just, you know, went poof.
personally speaking, Joe helped unlock vocal and theatrical parts of myself that I didn't even know existed inside of me. And for that, I am ever so grateful. So thank you so much, Joe, for your 30 years of service. And here's to many, many more.
These are kind of heavy. Hello. I'm Bailey Moon, the class of 2011. They told me to keep this short and sweet, but it's been a while since I've been up here as senior class president. So I make no promises. And I also am trying not to cry, but it's been that long too since I've cried. So also no promises. It is my distinct honor to present Michael Owen with the Earl Batchelder Award for Vision. Following a remarkable career as a principal dancer at American Ballet Theatre, Mr. Owen was the director of dance at Walnut Hill School for the Arts for 22 years. In choosing Walnut Hill, Mr. Owen understood the important balance of both an arts and academic education for young dancers. He led the department to become one of the premier dance programs for high schoolers in the country. His accolades are many, and his impact far-reaching. There's no better way to highlight the many students' lives he's touched than to hear from them directly through me. Here are a few excerpts from distinguished alumni. Mr. Owen told me the greatest dancers are able to make split-second choices on stage. What if a light cue is missed? Or the conductor starts to play your coda faster than you rehearsed? If we wanted a perfect performance, we'd be in film. He encouraged dancers to cultivate their minds and adaptiveness, not just their technique and artistry. He is loved so dearly by us all. Emilio Sturt-Dilly, principal dancer, Charlotte Ballet. The first classical variation coaching I had with Mr. Owen was for Le Corsaire. He emphasized details on how to command the stage. I'll never forget performing it at the Spring Gala in Boston. I'd catch glimpses of him in the wings, and he was just beaming with pride. Years later, when the Walnut Hill Summer Audition Tour stopped in Houston, there was Mr. Owen again, on the side, through the window, as I rehearsed the same solo from Le Corsaire, this time as a soloist with the Houston Ballet. That same proud look beaming across his face. He saw something in me that I didn't see in myself as a high school student. I owe so much of my work ethic and training to him. He elevated my dancing, and for that, I am forever grateful. Harper Waters, first soloist, Houston Ballet. As I reflect on my career, I realize how fortunate I was to have a teacher like Mr. Owen. He was there by my side through every triumph and setback. His presence was a constant source of reassurance and inspiration. His commitment to my growth extended far beyond the confines of the curriculum shaping me into the person I am today. Truly, he's the epitome of an exceptional educator, mentor, and friend. Blair Bagley, former principal dancer, Cincinnati and Orlando Ballet. Michael has been instrumental in my dance career. My dad just the other day told me, one of the first days I was performing there, age 11, Michael passed him after the show and gave him a look. That was just to say, you have to keep this kid in it. He will succeed. My parents have always been supportive, but knew that when it came to the dance world, they should listen to what an expert says. And that he is. And now, here, I am. He knows inherently what makes a dancer. He gave that to me each and every day. I find myself thinking back to the deep understanding of movement and technique he afforded me, and so many others. All my love and congratulations to Michael. Joe Walsh, principal dancer, San Francisco Ballet. And now my part. Mr. Owen was a steady figure throughout my time at Walnut Hill. A mentor, and a guide. You had to earn his praise, but it was worth putting in the work to achieve it. And while I could be among his greatest disappointments, me, of course, opting out of pursuing a career in dance, I'd like to think that myself and all of his alums are some of his very best achievements. For Mr. Owen, it wasn't about cultivating perfect dancers. It was about producing decent, disciplined, and kind human beings. It's his warm and loving spirit that has brought me back to Walnut Hill today for the first time in 12 years. Because an arts education matters. A teacher that makes a difference matters. It mattered to me, and it matters to the countless students who walked through the dance barn doors under his tutelage. See the crying, I told you. With that, Mr. Owen, from myself and from all of your students, we applaud you, we curtsy and bow to you, and we love you.
Thanks.
Like to be up here now following that? I mean, really. You know, I do have to say, and this is probably not fair, but Bailey, having been a dancer for a while, you couldn't see his feet, but I could. And they're like this and this. So he was still doing his dancing while he was celebrating Michael. Hello, I'm Betsy McClendon, and I have the joyous honor of awarding to Bob Keiter the Stephanie Perrin Award for Leadership. Bob was a trustee at Walnut Hill for 25 years on our board, as I said, 25, and chair for several of those, and truly was a man who has made Walnut Hill really move ahead, because if you heard his last name, Keiter. Bob was an investment banker in New York, and his wife, Jane, was a graduate of Walnut Hill Class of 60. Bob was reading some of the mail that came from Walnut Hill, and he was reading it and said, "It doesn't seem like things are going well there. What's happening?" She was like, "I don't really know." And he called the school, and he said, "You know, I'm not sure what's happening there." And they said, "Well, why don't you come on in and talk to us?" So Bob came to visit the school, you know, probably maybe one of the first times he's been here, and he talked about what his concerns were and thoughts about the school as his just transitioning into its new world of arts. And the person he spoke to was no lack of smartness and said, "Why don't you join our board?" So Bob, kind of that old adage of put your money where your mouth is, well, Bob did. So Bob came forth and he recognized that this school really needed a place. If we are having performers, they needed to perform someplace a little better than we've named it all different things. It used to be it's a dance barn, it was a theater with little risers. That's where a lot of it took place before Keiter was created. So Bob was the most generous and first donor to give the school $1 million to help begin the creation of Keiter, which was completed in 94. Many of us have been there many, many times. But Bob recognized that he alone could not be the only person to support the school, and he turned to his fellow board members, and he recognized that many of them weren't thinking about giving to the school, whereas today, as a board member, you know that is one of your first responsibilities, is to not only love the school, but to give to the school. So Bob put forth a big challenge, and he said, "We need 100% participation in the annual fund, because it's a not-for-profit school. Annual fund helps us with our expenses every year." And if they did that, he would give an additional $50,000 to the school right away. Well, thankfully, they did. And so the school continued to flourish. But you know, Bob was not only about money, he was very integral, working very closely with Stephanie and Lola Baldwin to create strategic plans, to think about the finances, to worry about the investments for our endowment plan. And he also wanted to make sure that he went on the road to talk to alums and other donors about, "You too should be giving to our school." So Bob is an investment banker in New York, a very, probably 6 feet two gentleman. Just saw him this fall, and he is equally just as tall. And he would come here quite serious, and he would be here. And if he had been here right now watching, you would now see Bob, like Bailey Moon, with tears in his eyes. Bob constantly was filled with absolute amazement at the students. And when I talked to him this week, sadly, he and Jane weren't able to come tonight, which he is very much missing. But when I spoke to him this week, he said, "You know, when I first started, it was sort of going to be okay. Now the school is certainly world class." So he is excited to have been a part of this growth. And I honestly tell you, if Bob had been here at our cocktail party before tonight, there is no question you would have heard him, because he has the most infectious laugh. And whenever Bob was in a room, you could be on the other side and you hear him laugh and you couldn't help but smile. So I would like all of us to honor Bob. If he were here tonight, he would have his Doers and Soda in his hand. He would be cheering for the school. And I suggest all of us, as Garrett Wells says, recognize that Bob really set the stage for all of us. And in your imaginary drink, or if you're still lucky enough to have one with you, raise it to dear Bob Keiter. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Reunion's going well for someone. Hi, everyone. My name is Ken Tai, and I'm the Director of Visual Art. And I'm here to introduce one of the recipients of the Roger Shoemaker Award for Innovation, Jack McCullough. Right. But first, a word about Roger. I count him among my most important early mentors, and will never forget his tireless advocacy for the arts, art teachers, and young artists at Walnut Hill. As my colleague Jim Woodside said the other day, his optimism was endless. The glass could be cracked and leaking, which it could be at that time. But Roger would always see it as half full. And I think half full is a state of mind where possibilities live and innovation can take hold. As Jack McCullough's teacher, I recall that the core of his formative experience was so much about play and playfulness. And I believe that has been a consistent thread in his artistry that still holds true today. When a few years ago he visited the art department to share his amazing creations and experiences, he was asked by a student where he found inspiration. Jack, without pause, smiled and said, "Everywhere." Jack McCullough co-founded the New York-based fashion label Proenza Schuler and serves as creative director alongside his co-founder and former New School of Design classmate, Lazaro Hernandez. After the debut of their collection in 2002, Proenza Schuler experienced a meteoric rise through the fashion ranks. Awarded with the inaugural CFDA Vogue Fashion Fund Award in 2004, the emerging brand was quickly established, including the 2003 Swarovski Award for Ready-to-Wear, the 2009 Accessory Designer of the Year Award, and the Women's Wear Designer of the Year Award in 2007, 2011, and 2013. Jack couldn't be here this evening, but we do have a word from him.
Hello. It's such an honor to be speaking with you today, and I'm thrilled to be receiving the Roger Shoemaker Award for Innovation. It feels like just yesterday that I was roaming these halls, so it's quite surreal to be receiving this award 25 years later. I have so many fond memories of my time at Walnut Hill, but what especially sticks out to me are the countless hours I spent in the art studios, experimenting with my craft and discovering who I was as an artist. I never would have been where I am today without the support and mentorship of the incredible staff at Walnut Hill. I owe a tremendous amount of gratitude to two teachers in particular, Ken Tai and Jim Woodside, who took me under their wings and inspired me to create. They gave me the tools I needed to grow as an artist and as a designer, and for that, I'm forever grateful. Additionally, they taught me the true meaning of taking risks, pushing boundaries, and thinking outside of the box. For me, these are the essential ingredients for true innovation, and I still carry these lessons with me to this day. Walnut Hill will forever hold a special place in my heart, and I feel so lucky to have been part of such an incredible community. Thank you again for this honor, and congratulations on 50 years of arts at Walnut Hill.
Hi, everyone. You having a great night? All right. My name is Eric Barber, and I'm proud to be your head of school at Walnut Hill. I want to echo Ken's words about the great Roger Shoemaker. Serving as the Dean of the Arts for nearly half of our time as an art school, Roger partnered with Stephanie Perrin and many other faculty members to consistently innovate. He tirelessly upheld standards of artistic excellence and cared deeply about Walnut Hill, and there's no denying it showed in his work. His leadership and devotion resulted in truly innovative programs, and it's my honor to honor another innovator for which his award is named. Mikko Niissanen was appointed Artistic Director of Boston Ballet and Boston Ballet School in 2001. Born in Helsinki, Finland, he trained at the Finnish National Ballet School and the Kirov Ballet School in St. Petersburg, Russia. He danced professionally with the Finnish National Ballet, Dutch National Ballet, Basel Ballet, and San Francisco Ballet, where he was a principal dancer for a decade. Mikko directed Alberta Ballet in Calgary, Canada from 1998 to 2001, also serving as Alberta Ballet's executive director from 1999 to 2000. Mikko is the recipient of the Finlandia Foundation's 2008 Arts and Letters Award, Boston's 2009 Ambassador for the Arts Award, and the 2007 United Nations Association of Greater Boston Leadership Award. As Artistic Director of Boston Ballet, Miko has redefined the company's image and reputation, cultivating a compelling and dynamic collection of classical, neoclassical, and contemporary repertoire. Miko's vision for the art of ballet has elevated the reputation of Boston Ballet to become a global leader in dance, one component of which has been a longtime relationship of premieres of the work of William Forsythe. Miko sees ballet as a global art form with dancers from around the world and has centered DEI principles in both racial diversity within the company, along with choreography, audience engagement, and programming choices. On a personal note, Miko's passion and uncompromising standards extend beyond ballet. As a high-level marine sports fisherman and incredible seafood home chef, everything Miko engages in is exciting, adventurous, and accomplished with an extremely meticulous approach. Miko had the vision and humility to understand that the traditional ballet school model at Boston Ballet School Professional Division was not going to serve his vision for the dancer of the future. The need for an integrated academic program, developmentally appropriate residential experience, and a focus on diversity, equity, inclusion, and exposure and engagement to other art forms led Miko to a search for a partner. Thus began the one-of-a-kind partnership between Walnut Hill and Boston Ballet, which in only 3 years has graduated 13 dancers into Boston Ballet's postgraduate program, along with many placements in some of the finest ballet programs in the United States and abroad. This year, Miko and I forged a bold vision, mission, and purpose statements to define our partnership as the only one of its kind in the world. Miko, thank you for your bold vision for the future of ballet. I am thrilled to call you a strategic partner, a colleague, and a friend. Congratulations.
Another truly innovative aspect of Walnut Hill of late is our Writing, Film, and Media Arts program. You saw an amazing example of this work in the film that accompanied Ravel's La Valse, but we're delighted to share with you right now an amazing work, hilarious if you know the people that are in it, and it was all made by a freshman, so please enjoy. Thank you.
Adam, right?
Should I know you?
I think so. Josh, we met when I was moving in.
Ah, the new kid.
Yeah, but I'm not so new anymore.
Yeah, you'll stop being new when you stop talking to strangers in the elevator.
What's going on?
Here we go again.
Soon. What does that mean? How long is this going to take?
Don't worry, kid. This happens all the time. Your laundry can wait. I'm the one missing my own retirement party.
So, what'd you do for work?
Physics teacher.
Congrats! I mean, don't you want to make it to your party?
No, I'd much rather be stuck in this elevator with you. I guess I don't feel like celebrating. It doesn't feel like my time is at an end.
But you're at a new beginning. I mean, doesn't it feel good to be free? I've realized that I'm now at an age where I have to get serious.
How do you know that?
Suddenly, I have to buy a tie for my best friend's wedding. The same best friend who in the fifth grade jumped off the swings, broke his wrists, and then had the nerve to blame it on a shark attack. Kid's insane.
It's not like one day we wake up and look in the mirror and decide to grow up. It just happens, and we don't even realize it.
I think it happens when we're sleeping.
We're in an elevator.
Well, see you around.
Yeah, okay. And don't buy a tie. You can always borrow one of mine.
See you around.
That was Larkin, and we're very grateful to her for sharing a really special piece. I'm going to vamp for a moment while we wait our next speaker, but I hope you're all having a great time, and to know that there is a delightful reception awaiting you when this is all complete, so something to look forward to. And now, many more drinks to come, yes. And now, here's our next speaker, Justine Han. Thank you.
It all the way from over there, all the way around. I've never even been backstage, and I can't see anyone up here. So we're here today celebrating 50 years in the arts at Walnut Hill, and there's one person in this audience who, more than anyone, probably in the whole school, is responsible for the success of the school today, and that is Stephanie Perrin. I think she needs to stand up, and we need to give her a round of standing ovation. Thank you, Stephanie, because honestly, the school is amazing, and it's we've been celebrating a lot of people who have made this school amazing, but I just really wanted to acknowledge all the work you've done, and thank you. My own daughter goes here now, and it is the most special place. She's in the audience there somewhere. So thank you. Thank you for giving it to me as an alum, to all these alums here, and to future generations of alums. So it's a special legacy. So, I am here to present the Betsy Payne McClendon Award for Philanthropy to a one Lola Baldwin. And there's a bit of neat symmetry to my presenting this award because I think when Betsy joined the board, I was a very young new development officer at Walnut Hill, and Lola was my boss. So, first a bit about Betsy. A graduate of the class of 1965. She's been on the board for a while, as have I, so guilty as charged. During her tenure on the board, she has been generous with her time, her energy, and her resources in a way that is pretty unrivaled in the school, especially among alums. She has overseen important transitions, worked to increase the resources and financial aid of the school, and has been at the forefront of the school's work around diversity, equity, and inclusion. There's simply no denying the indelible mark her leadership, service, and philanthropy has had on this school. And therefore, I'm delighted to name this award in her honor, and I am equally delighted to then present the award to Lola Baldwin, class of 1951. So, a little bit about Lola. So, when Lola first took the job as director of development, the endowment was $250,000. She says to me, "I thought they left off a zero." The year was 1989, which is the year after I graduated from Walnut Hill. It was a watershed moment for the school. The bold experiment that Earl Batchelder had launched had proven a success. The students were talented, but the school did not have the facilities to support their work or the endowment needed to make the school accessible for all. Enter Lola. During her 12-year tenure as director of development, Lola presided over three capital campaigns, raising millions of dollars to transform the campus with the building of the Kiter Center and other arts facilities. She launched the Board of Visitors and Overseers programs and organized numerous galas in Boston. They were annual galas in Boston and in New York City at Lincoln Center. She re-engaged countless pre-arts alums and recruited not just a few of her own personal friends who became longtime donors to the school. In short, Lola established the culture of philanthropy at Walnut Hill and that others have built upon to this day. And the endowment that I mentioned earlier, Lola's latest gift to the school, I'm pleased to announce, is a very generous endowed scholarship so that Lola Baldwin will always be giving to Walnut Hill.
Se- 74 years after I came to Walnut Hill. In the class, I was the class of 1951, but I came in 1949 after Smith College recommended the school to my mother, which is where I wanted to go. I loved my 2 years here, all of it, except for 1 month after I came and all my bras were stolen. At age 40, my husband suggested that with three in college, it was about time for me to get a job, which was pretty startling. But after going to Harvard College for a while to start development, I met Stephanie Perrin, who absolutely renewed my love for the school, and I came to work here. We planned an all-school reunion to get everybody back to show them how exciting the arts were here and all the wonderful things we were doing. The only trouble was the school really didn't look very good. And my husband, who loved the school, decided that instead of having signs that said, "Pardon our appearance," he made all these signs all over the school that said, "We're looking forward to." Well, guess what? We've made it. We look forward to it. The campus has never looked better. And the arts are very exciting and successful. I feel incredibly fortunate to have come to Walnut Hill and encourage our great alumni body to make gifts to the school. And my partner, Wendell Smith, and I are so happy to be here. And this is a special reunion, and I feel incredibly grateful for this honor. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hazen Peck and
Gloria, class of 95.
Class of 1983. We are here to present Cyril Gamborg Awards. Mrs. Cyril Gamborg was integral to the creation of Walnut Hill School for the Arts. Following an impressive career in dance, performing with the Metropolitan Opera Ballet and the Radio City Ballet. And she created and ran the dance department at Walnut Hill and then became the Dean of Arts until she went to Boston Ballet in 1985 to become the director of the Boston Ballet School. It is the spirit of gratitude and honor for the work she has done for the arts and education that the school has named the Impact Award for Artistic Excellence in her honor. Ms. Gamborg was the Dean of the Arts all for 4 years that I've been at school. And when I was a sophomore, I had the opportunity to play with the Boston Symphony Orchestra, and the whole school went at that time. Including Ms. Gamborg, and then, of course, later on, Mr. Gamborg was the principal oboist of the BSO, and after many years later, I found out that they were a couple. Sadly, Mrs. Gamborg passed away this past February, but we are delighted to we are very delighted that some of her family could join us in person today and also on the live stream tonight. So I would like to acknowledge Mrs. Gamborg's family. Could you please stand? Thank you.
Tonight's recipient of the Cyril Gamborg Award for Artistic Excellence, Ms. Joaquin Vian, has had the most meaningful impact. Under her tremendously inspiring teaching, she has guided some of the world's best pianists. We want to share with you the impact Ms. Vian has shown through her dedication to Walnut Hill And we would like to invite now to the stage some of Ms. Bian's students that are here with us tonight.
Please all come down quickly.
This is Ms. Bian's legacy. This is, along with hundreds and thousands of pianists around the world, and her kids and her grandkids are all around the world, but this is Ms. Bian's legacy.
I have to interrupt. I entered the school in 79, and this is the youngest who's going to graduate in 2025, current student.
This is the results since Ms. Bian first started teaching in 79 when Hae-sung was first a student. And she's still continually producing the most amazing students at both Walnut Hill School and the New England Conservatory of Music. Tonight is very, very meaningful for all of us that are Ms. Bian's students. And all of us, I think I can speak for all of us, that we all came to Walnut Hill for one reason, Ms. Bian. And we're all who we are today for one reason, Ms. Bian. And she was not only our teacher, but she was also our mom, she was our everything, and we all aspired to be like her when we grew up. So we're also honored to be here tonight to honor and celebrate her, and together, we would very much like to present this year's Sidel Gomburg Award for Artistic Excellence to our most beloved Ms. Bian.
Thank you very much. This shut me off, so I cannot talk anything. When people say that when you start to hear from people saying you look wonderful, that means you're getting old. So now, last few years, I started getting all these recognitions. That means I'm probably coming very soon to retire, and it's giving me message. But I am very, very honored, humbled to get this award, especially the name of Gomburg. I came to Walnut Hill mid-1970. There's a first piano teacher here was Signe MacPhail, and she invited me to teach some students. And then the summer program I taught. And the first time when I came here, I was completely taken beauty of the campus. And then when Hae-sung came to study here, I had no hesitation bring her here. And I still remember bring her to Mr. Taylor. That time he was a dean. And then Mrs. Perrin was academic dean. And since then, I demanded, asked so many, big, small favors for students, insisted, but I was never, never told no. And the school gave me always a yes, passed, gave me complete confidence and the freedom to teach here. And then when Hae-sung came here, I brought her here, and then the main reason was physical beauty, and then all other arts. I wanted her to learn through living here, open up herself. And so I think that was one of the best decisions I made for her. And then since then, there's so many came here. And I have one bad part of me, I remember every single student when they auditioned for me, what they did, what they said, all of that. There's an amazing, amazing journey for me
I came to this country 53 years ago. And my life up to that time was I was a PD for myself. Then after I started to teach, I became different person because by teaching, I learned how to give, share, suffer, be patient, make a lot of mistakes, learning from mistakes, and then sharing and love. So, of course, I've taught the conservatory all these years, but Walnut is a very special place for me because these young students never change their curiosity, their hunger for learning music, everything. And they believed in me so much, which these days after I get older, sometimes I said, oh my God, what did I tell them? And but as you can see, they turned out quite nicely. So now wherever I go, if I say my name, many people may not know, but if I say I am so-and-so's teacher, they all know. So that's maybe the most rewarding part for me these days. And I really look forward for upcoming of Walnut Hill under new directorship of Mr. Barber. I saw him 2 minutes after Evelyn's recital, but I could see through his eyes the vision and the curiosity and care and his nice smile. With a sharing, caring, but there's certain firmness. So I have a very good vibration for future of Walnut Hill. And if I believe, I don't know Latin, but I learned that education means in Latin, the lead out and pull out, mold, those things. So, I believe every human being, we are born with something in us, but most of us don't know. But as educator, our job is to help them to find themselves, help with them together pull out one string at a time. Then they can pull out themselves and weave beautifully and contribute to the mankind. And so I am very, very blessed that I can be in this journey. And thank you very much. Thank you for my students.
And this is just a little more quick surprise. This is a little encore that we prepared, me and Evren. Thank you.
thank you all so much for being here. And what a treat to celebrate 50 years of being an art school with all of you. Thank you. One of the reasons we are also here is that as of July 1st, 2022, we welcomed a wonderful new head of school. It's been a wild ride the past few years with COVID and any number of other things. And it really was a unique individual that would answer the call of duty to come and lead this amazing institution. And I've been very fortunate to have the opportunity to get to know this individual, and I couldn't imagine anyone else better for the job. And I don't have to say that, I assure you. But the but what makes him even better is what you're about to witness, and that is that he is also an amazing musician. And I think the last act for tonight is indicative of what is to come in the next 50 years of art. So please welcome to the stage our new head of school, Eric Barber. Thank you.
Thank you. What an incredible night, and those are really beautiful words. Thank you, Ms. Bune. Everyone having a good night?
Yes.
People getting thirsty?
Yes.
Okay, I'll keep it brief. I'm delighted to be your 13th head of school. It's been a blast this year. My wonderful wife, Joy, and our kids moved out from Los Angeles to Massachusetts. It's been a wild ride, a big year, but totally worth it. This is the first place I've been fully comfortable in my own skin and be my complete self. It's really a thrill to be here. Really want to give a great shout out to all alums. Welcome back to campus, and especially our powerhouse class of 1973 celebrating their 50th. Give it up for the class of 73. I'm excited to share one of the first alums that I met when I got to Walnut Hill. Garrett and I went down to NEC to Kathy Chan's amazing series in Jordan Hall and got to meet Chiwe Lo, class of 2010, I believe. And Chiwe and I sensed a really special energy about him. His artistry is truly incredible. And now we've become musical friends. And he's really a stellar thinker and musician. His expression is unlike anything you've ever heard before. So we will perform an improvisation, and then we will head to the bar. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.